Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of the James Wise Magic Review. It's been a while, but if you all are new here, if you're unfamiliar with who I am, I'm James Wise, I'm a magician. I upload videos such as me performing magic, me reviewing magic product reviews for other magicians, and also I do magic reactions. I react to other magicians' performances and kind of get my input and review. I hope you enjoy this video. So if you do, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you do hit that subscribe button, make sure you hit that little notification bell button so you will always be notified when a new video gets uploaded. And also smash that like button because that always helps. So without further ado, let's get right into it. Today we are going to be reviewing Method 1 by Kaylin Morelli.
Imagine this, you have a deck of cards, then any card is named, and that card appears blistered on your fingertips.
And you see how my finger glows kind of red? If it was this hot from like heat, it would be blistering my finger. This is what's crazy. I don't feel any pain, but you thought of any card?
No, how did you do that?
Oh my God!
No, you didn't!
No way!
Yeah.
Okay.
Can you put your hand out? Just like a table? I'm gonna take this. Okay. You're thinking of one card that's in 52 cards. You see how when I put my finger on this, my finger like kind of glows red a little bit? We know if that was actual fire or heat, that would blister my skin, right?
Yes.
Watch. But this is so odd. It almost looks like a two of spades.
What is that?
So as you saw from the trailer, this is a blister reveal effect. I've never really been a big fan of blister reveal effects. That's never really been my thing. And I'll tell you why in a moment. But first, let's get into the video teaching and the video quality. The instructional video is high quality. It's actually produced by Kayla Morelli's new magic production company called WUT, which stands for We Are Just Travelers Traveling Through Time. Long. And so it's definitely high quality video and audio, although it's definitely nothing like super high production or anything like that. But they're actually filming outside in this like mountain canyon area, very, very beautiful. So they're filming outside, and it's pretty much just Kaylin just talking directly into the camera, teaching you how to do this. Now the instructional video is just under 10 minutes long, and that seems pretty short, and it is. However, you still do learn everything you need to know in order to do this effect. The effect is pretty simple and straightforward, so it doesn't need to be like half an hour long or anything like that. Although I will say that this instructional video is only streamed on Vimeo, and that's it. There's no like official like website you stream it on. As far as I'm aware of, I don't think it allows you to download the video. Of course, it's no DVD because no one does that anymore, apparently. So it's only on Vimeo, which I don't really like. So what do you get when you open up your package? You do get this little black sleeve, showcasing Method 1. And inside of it is the gimmick that lets you perform this effect. On the other side of this, which I'm not going to show you, is the website link that you go to view the instructional video. Now, let's get into the question of, is this difficult? I would say this is in between easy to intermediate. It's not easy, it's not intermediate, it's somewhere in between easy and intermediate. And the reason why I say that is because the method is super simple and straightforward, like I said, so it's not difficult to actually get the imprints on your fingers because the gimmick's doing the work. However, I would say it's intermediate because it takes practice performing this a little bit, the timing, the misdirection, and all that good stuff, because you are getting the imprint completely blind. Now, Caitlin Morelli does go through and teach you exactly great methods so you can get the correct imprint on your fingers without getting a misprint or anything like that. But still, it will take some time to get used to doing it completely blind so you don't get a misprint or anything bad happening. And like I said, it's all about confidence. If there's some hesitation and you're getting flustered, the audience is gonna think something's weird is gonna happen, and you definitely don't want that. So it's just a beginner to intermediate in between there. So let's discuss some of the pros and cons. The pros being that there's absolutely no forces. You can literally just name a card or name a number, and you're able to get the blisters appearing on your fingers. Although if you did want to do a regular card, you know, pick a card, all that good stuff, you either would have to do a force or a peek of some sort to figure out what that card is. But still, it could be simple as just name out loud any card you want, and then boom, you've got it. Now, the gimmick is camouflaged very, very well, to the point where spectators can pretty much look directly at it and they won't really be able to see it. It's like anyone who's ever used a thumb tip, it's like super obvious when you know there's a thumb tip involved. It's just like, oh my gosh, that's so obvious, it's a thumb tip. I see it right there. I see it. It's so obvious and staring me right in the face. How is it possible no one can see that? But it's only because you know a thumb tip is involved. If you don't know a thumb tip's involved, it's completely invisible. And that's the exact same thing that happens with this gimmick. Also, there's no pocket work, and I think I really, really enjoy that. A lot of other blister effects involve weird pocket work. It's super awkward, and I've never really liked blister effects in the past. This solves a lot of the problems I had with other blister effects, and that's just so freaking cool. You can also borrow a spectator's phone to turn on the flashlight and do the blister reveal. And that's really, really cool. I think that makes it so much more powerful when you can borrow an object and do something magical with it. Now, the price for this is, I would say, pretty fair. It's pretty much right on the cusp of where it should be. It's not too high. Of course, it can always be lower, right? But it's definitely, I wouldn't say too high. It's $29.95, $30. I think it's good to go. Now, really, the only negative, the only con of this I could really think of is the fact that it's streamed on Vimeo only. There's nowhere else you can go. I just don't like Vimeo. I've always hated it. So that's really my only negative, I have to say. All right, so some final thoughts. Like I said, I absolutely love this effect, and I think you will too. So if you were thinking about picking this up, and I would definitely recommend, yes, get this effect. It's really, really cool. Caitlin Morelli has always brought it when it comes to releasing effects, so I definitely recommend you getting this. You will blow your audiences away, and I think you're really going to enjoy this. So thank you so much for joining me on this episode of the James Wise Magic Review. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, follow me on all my social media platforms, and I will see you guys next time.